Blood is vital for the pediatric blood and cancer patients because without it, they really can't survive. And so a lot of the things that we do unfortunately cause you to not have enough blood in your system or be anemic. And so when blood shortages happen like they are today, our patients can not survive due to that. And so it's an essential part of our therapy and how we treat our patients. Many of our patients who receive chemotherapy require transfusions in the middle of that to be able to get through the toxicity of the drugs we use. As well, in some of our populations, our sickle cell patients and some of our benign hematology patients, they get chronic transfusions to try and limit the severity of their illness. If we can't continue to do that every 4 weeks, their symptoms could be so severe that many patients could actually die without the blood that we need. We're definitely at shortage time. We are definitely not seeing as many blood units, and I think that as the time progresses, we are going to be in a dangerous shortage. So we really do need that, and we know that our community wants to help this hospital, and it's a really great way to do something by remaining safe. So if you're worried about the fact that you may not qualify to give blood, there's lots of websites out there that can tell you, come down and just see for yourself. If you know already you can't give blood, then that's a difference. But if you've never done it, come down and ask. Guarantee you that it's going to be a lot more lenient. I think as a blood and cancer doc, the one call to arms that I would say right now is go to your blood bank, donate platelets, donate blood. I promise you there are lots of kids in what I do for a living and lots of adults that require that blood today, tomorrow, and for the months to come. So if you feel like you really need to do something, if you give blood right now, you could be saving someone for real.